Now we're going to talk about which fabric you should choose depending on the pattern that you have chosen. I have two different ones here. One was for a knit and one's for a woven. So we'll talk first about the woven. And remember, the woven does not stretch on the lengthwise or crosswise grain. And patterns that would be made for that, a woven fabric, are going to have a little more ease because the fabric itself is not going to stretch. So the finished garment will have, you know, more inches than you are around to allow for ease. All right, so this is just a simple vest pattern. And on the second page of this PDF pattern, it has fabric suggestions. All right, it says linen, crepe, or any light suiting. And okay, so you don't want to go out and get something now super heavy, like a really thick wool. That would be considered a heavyweight fabric. But nor do you maybe want to get something really lightweight, like a lightweight silk. So it gives you some guidelines. But within those guidelines, you should have lots of choices. And if you have any questions about that and you're at a fabric store, ask one of the people who work there. They should be able to point you in the right direction. But that would be your suggestion for this woven. I here have a back envelope of a knit pattern. And I'm going to show you knits in just a minute. And it has under the suggested fabrics, size for stretch knits only. Now this is important because in a knit pattern, they're going to have negative ease. I just talked about ease that goes the other way. In a woven garment, you have your actual measurements. If your waist is 26 inches, depending on how the garment fits, if it's a close-fitting garment, the finished garment would not be just 26 inches. There would be ease in there, at least an inch, to allow you room to move. In a knit garment, sometimes there will be negative ease. So again, if your waist is 26 inches, the pattern might only measure 25 inches because it's meant to stretch and fit closely to your body. There are knit garments that are sweatshirts and loose-fitting garments that won't have negative ease. But because of that, if you took a woven garment and you used a pattern that was meant for a knit and it has negative ease, you wouldn't even be able to get it onto your body. So it's important that you look at the suggested fabrics and know if the pattern was designed for a woven or knit. Knits can vary a lot in the amount of stretch they have. And to further confuse it these days, there are wovens that have had spandex woven into it, and so it creates some stretch. It's still not considered a stretch garment. It's called a stretch woven. So you still cannot use that for a tight-fitting garment designed for knits. So don't get those confused. They're just the stretch that's in the woven is just for some comfort. All right, but this is a knit, and I'm going to talk about the properties of knit and how to lay those out like I did the wovens. But before I do that, I want to show you, I'm going to flip this around, and I want you to see right here, there is a gauge about how much stretch this pattern requires of knits.